Kirk Wicker and Aurora. Airplane. Whoa, there pulls up over into a maximum performance climb and rolls the airplane back to straight and level once again. Holy underwear Batman. That is a wild way to get started. See that all of our pilots are done here. Just to give you a short razzing here, Cape McKinley Wizard happens to be a legend in his own mind. He's an ex-Harrier pilot up until he was arrested, and his parole officer released him to be here as part of his anger management program, his work release, and he is a solo pilot because nobody else wants to fly with him. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause for the Northeast Raiders? And from the left, here's Kirk Wicker with Aurora, the 500 horsepower Super Stearman. Smoke goes up. Pulls into a 4G climb on the way up. Notice the dual exhaust and twin smoke systems. Here comes that rudder kick. Notice it's a left hand hammerhead stall this time. Back to straight level again, but just for a moment as Kirk pulls back on Aurora's stick. Coming up over the top, weight is right up out there. Rolls the airplane out. Notice the wonderful sound of that propeller as Kirk keeps rolling Aurora. That is not the engine that you hear. That is the sound of the propeller tips as they go supersonic. Back up onto the vertical, coming over the top, holding it there, inverted for a second. 1, 2, 3, and 4 points of a 4-point skip. An 8-point hesitation roll. He only went halfway around. Back up onto the vertical again. Let's watch for the kick. There it is, another hammerhead stall turn. Notice all of that beautiful smoke. Right now, Kirk Wicker is burning through more smoke oil than he is gasoline. Oh, I know this maneuver. There's the third side. Here's the fourth side. He's hanging by the belts at the top. Here's number five, number six, number seven. Here's the hard pull right there. It's the octagonal loop describing a stop sign in the sky. On to the vertical again, putting all 500 horsepower to good use. Rolls the airplane inverted, hanging by the belts. You know in that cockpit right now, he's up there going, woo-hoo. That's a half. Reverse cube and eight. There's one. Here's two. Number three. Number four. The 4-point hesitation roll. Now, for those of you who want to hear the engine on this airplane, wait until the propeller slap goes by. That low rumble that you hear is the sound of that Pratt & Whitney engine up front. This engine is fuel injected. No carburetor on this puppy. All right, there's one. Here's two. He's going to pull straight down right about now. And here comes the really hard pull right there. About five G's. That maneuver is called the square loop. And as you can see, the wake vortex is coming off of that airplane as the smoke scatters. You actually get to see what the wind is doing as he goes back up onto the vertical again, kicks that rudder over hard. Another hammerhead stall turn. These are turnaround maneuvers used to keep the airplane in a very tight space, which is what we have today. And there's the There's Kirk Wicker doing some aileron rolls. Now here comes the fun part. He's going to reposition the airplane. I bet you he does a wing over this time. No, actually, he doesn't look like he's going to do a wing over. He's just going to make it a gentle teardrop turnaround. Now, you know, the thing is, when that propeller is slapping like that, the tips are actually going supersonic on it. You're actually losing thrust. But it sure sounds good, doesn't it? Straight and level. Here comes the propeller onto the vertical. And he's going to continue up over the top. Brings it around. Well done maneuver. It's deceptively hard. It's called an inside or barnstormer loop. The tricky part is keeping it circular. Back up onto the vertical again. He's going to do a little woofer dill up here. No, actually, he's rolled it over. I'll bet you this is a half reverse Cuban. It sure is. With the half reverse Cuban, you start high, end up low. With a regular Cuban, you start low and end high. Slow rolling Aurora this time. Kirk Wicker at the controls. I don't know about you, but I think he's having way too much fun with this airplane. Back onto the vertical again. Watch for the rudder kick. And there it is. Whee, doggies. Tremendous amount of fun doing that maneuver because as you go over the top, if you do it right, you are absolutely weightless. Here it comes, the barrel roll. Describing the outside of a barrel in the sky. Way back when, back before World War II, this was called the PT-17 Stearman. It was a training airplane. It was also known as the Yellow Peril. Well, they called it that because the thing was a real handful on the ground. It's a big airplane with narrow, skinny little landing gear, and it's real easy to ground loop these airplanes. Here comes Kirk Wicker back in with Aurora. Sounds like he's got the power pulled back. Yes, he does. There we go. He's going to roll the airplane inverted. He's heading right up. And away he goes. There were over 10,000 of these airplanes built way back when. And of those, there are still about 1,000 of them flying today. It's a very popular airplane. And of course, they modified them into Super Stearman. Some big differences. For one thing, they more than doubled the horsepower. Doesn't make the airplane go any faster, but it sure gives it a really good climb rate. And now Kirk Wicker is up there cooling off. Got the power pulled back, getting ready, set up for his landing. You are going to get to see this airplane again later on today as part of our grand finale acts after the intermission. You're going to see Jane Wicker up there on top of this airplane. And then after that, she's going to climb all over it. And now we have a public service announcement. While Kirk Wicker is coming in for a landing, the police have told us that they have found a ring. And it's been brought over to their tent. They're over by the classic cars. If any of you have lost a ring, want to let you know that the police have it over there at their exhibition. So go on over there, and if you've lost it, I'm sure they'll give it to you. Here comes Kirk Wicker in for his landing. Hey, want to remind you, too, we have helicopter rides. For those of you who would like to see what this beautiful area looks like from the sky with all this fall foliage changing color, you can come on over here. They're under the wing of the Constellation, the Connie, that big airliner sitting here on the field. Come on over and check it out. Getting fired up right now. Dr. Smoke